slideshow one, feel free to ask me questions as I go through. I think the key issue is at this point, the project is going through.
You want to turn down the lights or anything?
Sure. A little more, it's gonna get really dark, let's see.
Key thing is it's going through its EIR stage right now, and the main sticking point is working for the city of Aurora Hills on how wide the underpass would be underneath the Aurora Road. So here we are right now, the underpass is there, near where the deer is on the freeway. We're working on buying some more land to improve the conditions, but this is the lay of the land acquisition wise. But I wanted to throw this slide in to show that there are actually trails that go through some of those properties from north of the freeway to south of the freeway that are all part of the planning process. Currently, right now, animals can only go either over the freeway or underneath the freeway, Liberty Canyon or a little culvert. So that's sort of the Spartan conditions we're working with. That's the underpass of Liberty Canyon. And the purple is what we have now where animals can go and then go behind the office building. The Caltrans is right now in the process of moving the fencing so we can get that green area. And in the meantime, while the overpass is being built, we will have that whole purple area available for animals, and it's being landscaped in cooperation with the RCD and the LRCA. There's all kinds of little bells and whistles with fencing and that type of thing that can be done to enhance that connection. In the meantime, while the overpass is being built, and in addition, fencing all throughout the interchange to funnel animals in there, and that will also work to funnel animals to the overpass. And the fencing that Caltrans is putting in runs all the way from Chesbrough Road back over towards Lost Hills to raise it up so that animals don't go over. So here we are now, the overpass would be a little bit off from the Liberty Canyon interchange where that you see it there diagrammatically. And we'll still work in concert with the underpass where the road is too. So it would just be a box beam type bridge like that with vegetation on top. And there's a lot of biological constraints as you come across on the other south side of the freeway that Caltrans has to work around. Here's just a Caltrans sort of diagram to show you how it worked. First you have to go over the freeway, and the next slide goes to the right over Aurora Road, and then over Aurora Road. So it's a two-part component. It doesn't have to be that way, but that's the optimal situation. And this is sort of a reverse direction where it goes over the freeway and not Aurora Road. Aurora Road on the left now. And then watch how this gets covered up over Aurora Road. There's a mound and a tunnel. And this will show it again.
Did you say two parts
of
the bridge?
Well, two parts in the sense that
the next one, the previous one.
Oops.
Paul, can you give us some dimensions?
Yeah.
What kind of distance is it?
I'm sorry, I just extend the backwards and forwards are opposite. There you go. The dimensions, it's 165 feet wide and 165 feet long when it's on top of the freeway. Here, there, we have that big fill slope that goes along the Aurora Road. That's hundreds of feet long, so it has two arms that come down to the base of the Aurora Road. And then the second part here, where the Aurora Road gets covered up, there's a tunnel under Aurora Road, or over Aurora Road, and then it would spill out again wider, and that's about 150 feet long, the tunnel. That's here, would be covered up. This just shows it from a different aerial perspective what it looks like without Aurora Road and with Aurora Road. So the issue is how to, and that black area shows the length of the tunnel, the red area shows the length of the bridge. And notice how they're kind of offset, the bridge heads due south and the other tunnel over Aurora Road, the bridge over Aurora Road is more diagonal. Notice too that the overpass coming from the north side of the freeway headed up, it's actually the freeway deck can move up, so there's a really large altitude to drop down, creating problems with the slope and needing to not have to minimize that slope as much as possible. It's just a side cut to show you the kind of idea of the slope coming down over the road. And here's a close-up of the grading footprint. One of the big issues is going to take the toe of the slope out towards Burr Road because there's a riparian area there and a lot of oak trees. And as you make the tunnel wider on Burr Road, it makes that slope go farther out and do more damage. So the issue is having a city of Burr Hills, the amount of bike lanes it wants and sidewalks and things of that nature, enough travel lanes to keep the tunnel narrow enough to avoid this big heritage oak tree and some other oak trees. And just another view of how that looks. I'll get to the dimension stuff in a minute. This is what the slope looks like from Burr Road looking up to the freeway. The power lines would have to be raised or moved. You notice it's a very steep drop, and so to drop it down from 16 feet above the edge of the freeway there down to the edge of Burr Road is a very steep slope. If you take it over Burr Road, you can get into the 3-to-1 type range. Then we've got the stream crossing under the Burr Road too, so you can't bring the crossing too far downstream. This is sort of the edge of the oaks that we have to worry about at the toe of the slope. And the green bars on the right kind of represent how the toe of the slope will or will not go into the oak woodland and where the stream is, depending on the width of the tunnel, if you get that sense. This is a rendition for a 48-foot wide tunnel, and we're hoping this is what Caltrans is pushing, sort of a tension between where Hills wanting to be 70 feet wide, 20 feet high, Caltrans wanting to go 16 and a half and 48. Things are hopefully moving more in the 48 direction. That's what 60, I think, looks like. And you can see it pushes the slope out way into the riparian area, and it becomes a lot steeper if you go the wider undercross. This is what they're again trying to avoid. Some interesting kind of block diagrams. You get a feel for how the mountain, just the re-extension of the mountain across the freeway, and putting up, slapping over the freeway, the terrain back to where it used to be. And another angle on it. Freeway and the tunnel on the right. And again, that last slide, maybe what the whole, in its full glory, will hopefully look like in the not too distant future after Caltrans finishes its EIR and moves forward with the planning and specs. But the thing that's holding it up is the issue of how wide that tunnel needs to be. Piece of line picture from a guy who he ate an entire deer. And he has a big stomach. So there's a couple fun little slides in there.
Any questions?